हेलो यशस्वी, हाउ आर यू?
I'm fine.
ऑल राइट. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंग्रेचुलेशंस ऑन दिस पॉडकास्ट, एंड वी होप दैट यू नो यू डू रियली गुड. सो वुड यू लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ?
श्योर. माय नेम इज यशस्वी तलरेजा. आई स्टडी इन द स्कूल शिक्षांतर. आई एम इन 7th ग्रेड एंड द बुक दैट आई हैव रिटन इज मैजिक विद इन द आर्केन ऑर्डर.
यस. So I read your book and it's a very interesting book. Is it the first book that you have written?
No, it's actually a sequel to my first book, which is Magic Within.
Okay, all right. That's really great. So, the title that says Magic Within the Arcane Order, what does that mean, and how did you come up with the idea of writing this book?
So I've always been a fan of fantasy series. So one day I just came across the idea of using this magic within. The first phrase just means finding something special about you other than magic, the magic that is inside you,
All
basically.
right, so
And
as
the Arcane Order is the main, you can say, main one of the main members in the book, hence the name.
yes. So there's a, it's a very interesting book, and as I read that each chapter had a, kind of a title or a tagline given to it. So because you
That
know go ahead, please go ahead.
was because of I have actually written the book in the perspective of two people. So I
Okay.
named the chapter to make it easier for people to understand who is it.
Whose perspective that part particular chapter is about. All right. So
Yes.
I think that there are two people. One of them is named Jason Gilbert, and the other one is you.
Yeah. So I named him after me because I really relate to the character.
All right, and how do you relate to this character?
He is energetic, joyful, and he'll never shy away from a fight. So I feel like that's something that I kind of do. Never not accept a challenge. Never backing down, always trying to make my point. So
That is
that's
one
why
great quality for, somebody that young. And I believe that, book writing has also been kind of a challenge because, writing in a book and becoming a published author at such a young age is a huge achievement in itself. So when you started writing your first book, did you, I mean, before starting it, did you ever think of becoming an author yourself?
actually, I have been writing poems and stories since the age of 6. I was inspired by my mother to write them.
Oh, that's
She's
very
also kind
interesting.
of, you can say, an author to
All
me.
right.
So basically, from her, I got inspired. So I've been writing poems and books since the age of 6. So yes, it was in my mind that I could maybe be an author. And through this platform, BreeBooks, I was able to express myself. So
And
really.
when you started writing your first book, Magic Within, and you completed it. So did you, I mean, while you started writing the book, did you think that you would want to write a sequel to this book, or did the thought of writing a sequel just came later?
No, I actually had planned this for the book that there will be 3 parts.
Oh, that's interesting. All right.
So I actually had planned this from the start, so I arranged the book in that order.
And it's all fantasy.
Yeah, it's all fantasy because it's kind of like a world that I can go to that's not actually the real world. So
That's
it's
really
kind
great.
of.
That's really great. And there are some chapters that say, the riddle, the plan, and others also. So, this kid, which is you, of course, which is named after you, goes on an adventure to kind of, find something or find something interesting. So what is the story or the plot about? I mean, if you want to give a brief about your book to the readers, what would that be?
So Basically, I actually hinted the start of the second book in the first book only by in an epilogue. So, there was basically there is this guy named Jason Gilbert, who was the main character of the first book. He set out to find the Arcane Orders, which is basically you can say three demigods who basically created the universe and to save humanity from their wrath. And the Yashasvi's basic plot is to stop the war between him and the antagonist from going on. So to stop it, he needed to find a set of stones known as the Triumviric Stones so that he could actually harm this monster and prevent him from destroying his whole, you can say,
The
you can
universe,
say,
the mess,
yeah,
the world that.
basically.
All right.
So in the end, the plots merge with the Arcane Order actually helping Yashasvi to beat the antagonist.
That is great. And how did you get the idea of all of those, the characters and the plots that you have written? Now that you say that, there are stones and these are the demigods. So do you read a lot of fantasy
I read a
books?
lot of books. So I inspiration from writing one was my mother, and one that I actually got the passion from writing from reading. So I've read a lot of books. So it's kind of like what came to my mind as the
That
first
is
thing.
great. That is great. And what if I were to ask you to name at least one or two books that are your favorite, what would those books be?
I would say Wings of Fire and Percy Jackson.
That's amazing. And now that you have written two books, and as you just discussed that you had already hinted about the second book in your first book, I was gonna say that I read the epilogue of this book as well, and there's some hint already hidden in this one. I was gonna ask you next that it's kind of an open end, and it makes the reader think that maybe there's more to the story. So now we know that you had already planned three books, and I will be really interested in reading the third part as well. Also, because you say that you have you love reading fantasy and you like reading and you like writing as well. So are there other genres that maybe in the future you would want to explore or write a book about?
I would most probably I would write something about mystery
Oh, that's amazing.
because all the books I've read are usually have been a mixture of fantasy and mystery, but there are a few books that are just like mystery only.
That's great. And since you've been a writer from a very young age, even before you started writing a book, so I understand that you have the ability to understand what to write and how to write. However, now that you have written a pu book and you've published it, if there was just one advice that you could give to, new authors or the budding authors, what would that be?
The first thing I would give is that when your book gets published, don't get nervous like I did. And always recheck your book before submitting, at least once or twice, every single page for any mistakes, like you do in the paper, recheck all the questions. Just like that, before publishing, you should recheck each book, each page. So that's one advice I would like to give.
And you've also put in, interesting pictures in your book. So did you also research, while or before writing your book, or did you just plan the plot and you had kept that plot in your mind and it was just, you were flowing with whatever was coming to your mind?
I was actually just flowing with whatever was coming to my mind. I had the plot planned and I knew when I was gonna do what page. So, yeah.
All right, so I assume that you already have planned the third part as well, and that what's going to happen.
Yes, I'm in like the middle of planning it. I've decided who's gonna be the antagonist and how the story is gonna go. But I just need to work out some few kinks.
And
thing.
because while writing such a complex story, you also have to, think about multiple characters, who the antagonists or the protagonists are going to be, what all characters are going to play, what important roles. So, because, as you have been reading and you have also been writing, but again, writing a book is a lot different and more challenging than writing poems or, short stories. So has it in any way kind of improved your comprehension skills or maybe, helped in your academics, something of that sort?
Actually, it's helped with me. It's actually helped me a lot in literature. Especially now that in school they're starting narrative story writing. So in that, it's really helpful for me. Since that, I've already written a book and I have to narrate the short story. So it gets quite easy for me in school and studies.
Right. And when you got your first printed copy of the book, how did that feel?
I felt like I was on top of the world, that I could do anything. I
Definitely.
was really happy and excited for the things that were going to be coming ahead.
Right. And I understand that, becoming an author is not just about writing an interesting story or, writing the best book that there is. However, it also involves a lot of, marketing and promotion of your book. So, did you come up with any kind of, techniques to promote your book, or did you take some help from your book?
Actually, I took some help from my father. He spread the word of my book around the his office, and we actually planned a book launch for the
That is
book.
great. So, you also have become an entrepreneur and not just a published author. And it is a, it's a great lesson in itself. Also, this entire journey, it's not just about you. It's about, how from writing a book to publishing it to, promoting it to the world for them to read. It's a journey in itself. So if I were to ask if, while writing the book or your entire journey, if there were any challenges that you faced, and how did you overcome all of those challenges?
So in the time of my second book, I was actually having a writer's block. I wasn't able to figure out how to do the chapters for a little while. So in that, my mother actually and my father and brother helped me a lot in that. They helped me get through these challenges. And with that, I was able to get over that writer's block and I was able to finish the book before the end.
That is great. And also, did your mother read your book once you finished it?
Of course, she read the book.
And then you published it,
She was
or did you publish it before and then she read it?
No, she actually read it before the publishing.
That is great. So she kind of also, corrected some of your mistakes that you might have
Like,
made.
yes, punctuation mistakes and spelling mistakes. She helped me with those.
So it's a collective, process of book writing, and one huge achievement, not just for you, but for your parents as well. And you must have also shared your book with your, friends and your family, and what were their reactions to it?
They were really happy that I had published another book. They actually bought it and even commented on my book
That is
and
great.
gave me a 5-star review.
That is amazing. That is amazing. Thank you, Yashasvi. Also, if there is anything else that you would want to share about your book, please go ahead.
So actually, there is one thing I would like to share about my book. It's actually inspired by one of my old stories that it was written. I actually wrote a story about a monster being born. So basically, that same monster is the one that I kept in my book as the antagonist for the second one. So that's a little thing. And that keep an eye out for the third book because the antagonist won't be resting anytime soon.
That is amazing. Also, it is very, very good that you've kept a part of an old story in this book, because now you've kind of preserved it for a lifetime in the form of a book. and it won't get lost anywhere in your memories. When you grow up, you will have a, kind of a nostalgic souvenir to look back to of all the stories that, because when you are going to read this book, you will remember, the other story also that you'd written when you were a child. That is great. And if you were to kind of just tell me one favorite part of your book right now, what will that part be?
It would definitely be the ending of the book where the Arcane Order actually gave a big speech about how that we have ruined the planet and how we can correct it. So about learning from your mistakes. So that would most probably be the favorite part of my book, or maybe the one from the first book where Jason's mentor inspired him to go on a journey and explore himself.
That
To
is great.
find the magic within.
So, despite it being a fantasy book, it is also one, maybe a learning experience for the readers to actually, maybe they can relate to the book in a way that, there is magic within all of us and that we are capable of, much, much bigger things than we expect ourselves to, be capable of. So that is a very interesting read. And I'm hoping to read your third book soon. Congratulations once again. Thanks for connecting with us. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Bye.